and your belt. They've got the star and crown. I've got the belt. Remember that. Because I'm definitely out here in the community trying to crack my whip to make you see that unity is needed. But most of you people already know that unity is needed here in this community. We've had quite a few donators to the Unity event, and I'm pretty sure there are more to come. Can anybody tell me what time it is? Because homeless people don't have watches.
It's 12:27, baby.
Thank you, darling. I really appreciate that. I really, really do. And that's our cameraman, Sky, for all you local people that don't know him. He will do private parties. He's our up-and-coming, he's gonna be really big, I'm telling you guys now. You guys are looking at the next multi-millionaire bachelor. So women, you better get him now. Alrighty then, now that I've auctioned off a man, I'm looking for some food. Has anybody out there got any food for me? I'm still hungry. I've got this piece of green, yummy looking candy that I had. Oh, it's so good. Oh, yes, it is. You guys know I'm real country, of course, walking around barefooted. That's why my feet are so big. I did a lot of walking around in the country, in Louisiana, with my shoes off. And I wear about a size 12.
Yeah!
More to kick you with. If you can't get into shape, get on board, work for God. That's your only boss. You just work with these people down here. Realize that. Message. Another thing, let me think. Oh, that's really hard for me to do. I can't think, you guys. I don't know how to think. I've got to have help. And, you know, somebody told me this a couple of days ago, and I've come to realize it was a man, you know how us women are, that told me that women need guidance in their life. We do. Because I'm going to tell you guys something. When I came here, I was on fire for God. Nobody but God. I couldn't meet a stranger in my life. There's nothing that I wouldn't do for anyone. And I kind of went a little buck wild with it. I can kind of say I kind of pressured Border Patrol into coming on board with me for Christmas, for the toys, for tots. Or is that name already taken? Well, it doesn't really matter. We did it. Kind of forced Juvie, twist their arm, made them give me bikes to children that needed it. And now, I kind of just jumped on out there and kind of just said, well, I'm going to be a one-woman committee. I don't need to bother my church with this. And I went ahead and started doing it. Well, my pastor, Bob Myers, knows my heart. He's known my heart since I've moved here, and he's known that I've wanted unity in the community. This is the man that I'm talking about that told me I need guidance. And you know what? When you have a pastor, he's supposed to guide you. Did you know that? Well, I didn't, but now I do. I
want to
tell you, I love my pastor out there. Because when I came to my pastor and I said, hey, Pastor Bob, I got a bright idea. I want to have unity in the community, and I want you to get that letterhead to that church, and I want you to write up this letter, and I want you to write it to this, and this person. And you know what? He did it.
They're here, sir.
He didn't change a word. We sat there in that office until he typed this, and this letter to that person. And he was on his way out of town, but he was doing the Lord's work. And he couldn't leave until the Lord's work was done. And I commend my pastor on that, because he kind of got, like I did for a minute there, forgetting that we're not just the only part of the committee. We got a whole church backing us. And First Presbyterian of Brawley, we got some wonderful people over there because for Christmas, I ran those folks so ragged I thought I would give them a 6-month break. So that's why I went to my pastor and says, hey, pastor, write this and that letter, and this and that letter to that other and this, and we'll just put it together. You don't worry about it. You going out of town, I got it. Well, pastor, does it look like I got it?
Got it.
He says, I got it. So I've got it from top authority, my clergy, and my pastor, and my brother in Christ out there. He says, I got it. I hope you guys are enjoying the show, and I hope you enjoy the karaoke later on. Hopefully more people will come out. Man, it's hot out here than a firecracker. For a minute there, I thought Satan, but he turned around. He got scared. I would like to thank my staff over here. That's Manny Water. I didn't want to leave you guys out. I've got 2 students from Brawley High School. They're donating their Saturday doing community service. So don't forget to go over there and work them. Get you some water. That's what they're here for. Work them to death. When I send them home to their mamas, they're going to be so tired, they're going to do nothing but fall over and go to sleep. Thank you.
What's your birthday?